Jim, let me bring Jim DeMint into this, because I want to come back to Pete's point. Justice Kennedy is using the word dignity over and over again. He's saying you can't demean gay and lesbian couples. You can't discriminate against them. Now, let's be honest. In both of your backgrounds, Ralph Reed and Jim DeMint, you will be viewed in many quarters as being intolerant of gay rights, intolerant of gays, going back to the Christian Coalition, your time as senator, some of your past comments. How do you oppose, how do you answer Justice Kennedy saying to oppose gay marriage is to deny dignity to people who deserve equal protection?
What I'd say, David, is he is denying dignity to the millions of Americans who, for moral or religious reasons, believe that gay marriage is wrong. As you just said, you've got 37 states where the people have decided that they want to protect the marriage between a man and a woman because they know that that's the environment where children can thrive and succeed. I mean, that's been proven. So it's not about the desires of adults. It's really about the best environment for children. We're talking all about politics, but the reason governments at the state level and the federal level have recognized marriage between a man and a woman is because it's better for our country and it's better for children.
You know, Justice Kennedy addressed that issue specifically in his ruling.
He talks about children as well.
He says that by denying marriage rights to same-sex couples who have kids, you're humiliating and demeaning those kids by denying their families equal protection under the law by the parents who are raising them and who love them and who make their family. So we can put it in the interests of children, but I think that cuts both ways, and I think the ruling cuts against that argument. I mean, gay people exist. There's nothing we can do in public policy that makes more of us exist or less of us exist. And you guys have been arguing for a generation that public policy ought to essentially demean gay people as a way of expressing disapproval of the fact that we exist. But you don't make any less of us exist. You just are arguing in favor of discrimination. More discrimination doesn't make straight people's lives any better.
David, I really can't let that go. I mean, this suggestion that because somebody wants to affirm the institution of marriage that they're ipso facto intolerant, by that argument, Barack Obama was intolerant 14 months ago. By that argument, 342 members of the House, 85 members of the Senate, including, by the way, Joe Biden, Harry Reid, Pat Leahy, who all voted for this law, and Bill Clinton, who signed it into law, were intolerant and motivated by an animus and a hatred for gays. But we're talking about when they built. Obama was 14 months ago. Was he a bigot 14 months ago?
Nobody's calling anybody a bigot.
Was Hillary Clinton a bigot when she took that position in 2008?
But to suggest that you are
motivated by a hatred for somebody else because you believe that the foundation enculturating and socializing institution of Western civilization is something to be protected.
Can I tell you this? I got to say this. The same argument was made in defense of white supremacy against African American people. The same, very same argument. It will destroy civilization. It will undermine the American family. It will challenge our civic institutions. It will unravel our civil polity. The reality is the same arguments were made in behalf of those. And I will go
on the
limb and say this.
So the Pope is George Wallace?
No, I'm saying this, not George Wallace. I'm saying to George Washington. My point is this, is that in the American culture, yes, people can change their mind. They can evolve. They can grow. They can think that one thing was true then, another thing is true now. Most Americans believed 50 years ago one thing about issues of race. Now they believe something different. As we make a move toward progressive realization of what is enlightened viewpoints, your affirmation of marriage for those who are heterosexual goes against people who are affirming their rights as same-sex people.
Let me get in here to Pete Williams. With all of these points in mind, the Supreme Court deliberately did not answer this core question.
Well, that's right. With all respect to Mr. Reed here, it did not reject the argument of equality here. It just sidestepped it with great relief. It was only too happy to find an off-ramp and say, you know what, the parties that came here, the proper proponents, don't have the proper legal standing. It was obviously clear from the oral argument that the court is nowhere near wanting to take on this question. They would not like to see this come back. There were two cases pending in the Supreme Court after it decided these cases from two other states that raised the core question. The court said, you know, we're just not going to hear those now. So having done all this, it does not want to see these cases back on its doorstep for quite a while. It wants the states to have this very argument that you're having this morning.